Ella Burakowski is the daughter of Holocaust survivors and the author of Hidden Gold, A True Story of the Holocaust. She joins me now from Toronto, and it's good to have you on the program on this day. Ella, hello.
Hi, Beverly.
Let me ask you your thoughts on this ceremony, on this day, the importance of marking it. It was obviously very powerful. What stood out to you? What went through your mind on this day?
That's a very interesting question, because before I came here, I was watching it live on your CTV channel, and it was a very powerful program. And the one thing that really stood out in my mind more than anything, one of the gentlemen, one of the survivors who spoke, he said that he had to make it really count this time because he would never be at another commemoration. And that really hit home with me, because as they panned the audience, and I could see the faces of the survivors, and you have a really good idea of their ages, it's very scary to know that these eyewitnesses are perishing. They're not going to be around to tell their stories anymore. That job is going to be the job of the second generation, the third generation, and everybody who hears their stories.
And why it's so increasingly important to document all of this, which you have done in your book, Hidden Gold. Tell me about your story.
Well, I am the daughter of two Holocaust survivors. My parents were both from Poland, and my parents never really spoke about the Holocaust at all. And my mother died when I was 14 years old, so I never heard her story. I was able to write Hidden Gold through the memories of her brother, my uncle, who was 12 years old. My mother was hidden in a barn for 2.5 years with some of her family and two other people. It was a small secret enclosure in a barn, and they were there for so long. They were starving. They were terrified. They were always scared of being caught. It was a horrible thing. But another interesting fact that I learned was that when I was doing research for the book, I went to the United States Holocaust Museum, and I didn't know anything about my father either. And he didn't talk about the Holocaust, but the researcher there asked me if I wanted to look anybody else up. And yes, I said I wanted to look up my father, Fischel Burakowski. And she punched in his name, and out came a chronological order of what happened to him in the Holocaust. He was in two ghettos in a forced labor camp, and he was eventually liberated from the Dachau concentration camp. He died in 1995, and his story died with him. I knew none of this. My sister knew none of this. It was a horrifying time. I just remember standing there in front of the researcher and crying because I couldn't get his story from him.
Wow. It must have been so difficult to even think about and digest the story of your parents in this way. But yet you took the step, you went further with that. You wanted to document it.
I wanted to document it. It was very important for my uncle to have his story. He was unlike my mother. He would tell his story to anyone that would listen. And really, I only wrote the story for my family for generations to come. But it got picked up. It was published by Second Story Press. And it took on a life of its own. It became part of the Forest of Reading program for the Ontario Library Association. It won an award in its category, and it's in schools now across Ontario. I do presentations in schools, and I try and do my part to keep the memories alive.
You had your mother until you were 14, you said, and when you learned the story of the Holocaust and what she went through, and also your father, what did you kind of think about your parents at that point, looking back?
You know what? I didn't know my mother as much more than my mother. But through writing Hidden Gold, I was able to walk in her shoes through the darkest time in her life. I literally was able to feel her fear. I was able to feel her courage. And I was able to feel her power. I didn't know anything of this about her. And she was a completely different person than the woman who raised me. She always seemed to me to be rather meek and rather scared. And that is not at all how she was to survive the Holocaust.
And tell me what your thoughts are on this day. And you mentioned, I mean, obviously, you know, there aren't many survivors left. And in fact, in the 70th anniversary of the liberation, there was twice as many survivors as there were there today. About how important it is that we learn those lessons, that we go over those stories, because for so long afterward, a lot of people were like your mom. They're very silent about it.
They were very silent about it. And all we have are their stories to keep going. But it's very important because as anti-Semitism continues to grow globally, and as intolerance and hate and bigotry become staples in our daily news, the words never again and never forget become more important today than they ever were before. And in the words, if I may quote Elie Wiesel, the author and professor, he made a quote and he said, "The opposite of love is not hate. The opposite of love is indifference." And we just don't have that luxury to be indifferent. We must speak up. We must help. When we see something wrong, we must move forward. We can't be silent. We don't have that luxury.
Well, it's an incredible story. Do you know that all of the things that you learned later in life and that you were able to write it down with such a wonderful book so that others can learn from it. I really appreciate hearing your story, Ella Burakowski. Thank you so much.
Thank you.